similar plan was made in Rabbit Hole.
I need to know that you're on a level with me. No matter how far this thing goes, I need to know that we're good. Because if what just happened here is happening everywhere, we need to get to that bunker Danny told us about, and we need to get there now.
What are you talking about? You know something.
I had a sneaking suspicion, but I wanted more information first. All the signs were there, sure, but I didn't want to scare anyone. You'd have called me crazy, because it is crazy. It would have made more sense if we were on the brink of an all-out invasion. But this... I didn't think we'd actually let something like this happen. I thought we were smarter than that.
Let what happen?
Because my primary client works in the defense sector, I spent a lot of time studying the cost-benefit analysis of military campaigns. There was one program in particular that terrified my client the most. A simple three-stage maneuver that could topple a country's government from within. First stage was isolation. Disable their communication and transportation. Make the target as deaf, dumb, and paralyzed as possible. Setting them up for the second stage. Synchronized chaos. Terrorize them with covert attacks and misinformation. Overwhelming their defense capabilities, leaving their weapon systems vulnerable to extremists in their own military. Without a clear enemy or motive, people would start turning on each other. Done successfully, the third stage would happen on its own.
What's the third stage?
Civil war. Collapse. This program was considered the most cost-effective way to destabilize a country. Because if the target nation was dysfunctional enough, it would, in essence, do the work for you. Whoever started this wants us to finish it.
We developed techniques on how to manipulate populations. You know, you saw the research, the algorithms of control. We used them to undermine elections, sway public support, and elect favorable regimes. All that mattered was that those governments fell in line with US interests. But Crowley didn't see it that way. Crowley saw it through darkened eyes. He started selling our cutting-edge psyops as a service to foreign governments and to businesses on the side. Highest bidder all come. I'd been out there, tracking him, hunting him, watching him help oligarchs and dictators. You pick his scumbag, Crowley's worked for him. Almost had him once. Even stopped a genocide. Well, almost. But now he's not working for hire. He's got so much money, it's not about that anymore. It's about power. He wants power. He wants a regime of his own, and he wants it right here.
Yeah, come on. How do you know that?
Because I wrote the book. Chapter 1, undermine people's faith in the media so they begin to doubt the bloody nature of the truth. Chapter 2, polarize factions in society. When people stop seeing the other side as human, then human rights ceased to be an obstacle. Chapter 3, marginalize the intelligentsia. People stop listening to experts and they become malleable. That sound familiar? Chapter 4, now you're going to need chapter 4, elect a candidate under the guise of restoring order. Someone smart, someone charismatic, but someone who can be controlled.
What's chapter 5?
Oh, there's no chapter 5. Now the country's yours. Oh, yeah. The bottom line is it's happening right now. A lot faster than I thought it would. Maybe by even the next election.
That's... yeah.
At the end, the Rosie finds the house with red door that portrays safety and the blood of Jesus. There she goes to the bunker, and we see the date September 17th with emergency alert of White House and cities under attack. On another screen there is another message if image is flipped. Finally she watches Friends season 10 episode 17 to 18 or 117. One thing I forgot to mention is that Clay is wearing Bikini Kill shirt. Bikini Kill is a feminist band that promotes female revolution, but it is actually a reference to Bikini Atoll nuclear bombs. And Archie and Rose say, "Obey NASA," with their shirts. This is because when the aliens come, people must listen to NASA, who will be one of the first government agencies to talk about them. It was interesting that they combined the shirts right after the annoying noise. Also, the constant visual of Friends was interesting. Julia Roberts played in an episode called The One After the Super Bowl. Yes, The One After the Super Bowl. The episode starts where they are on the set of fictional movie called Outbreak 2, Virus Takes Over Manhattan. The main cast is a monkey, so we can assume the virus is monkey flu. This may be another reason why they keep bringing up Friends. Rosie is symbol of obsession of entertainment, and she is desensitized to what's happening around her. But after spending time without technology, she became aware. Rose was ignored the whole time,